Good evening, everyone. I'm Leah Cooper with your JCN News for this Thursday, June 13th. Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis assuring that a company has been chosen to investigate the circumstances surrounding the removal of the former Bahamas Power and Light Board led by former Chairman Darnell Osborne. According to Dr. Minnis, he and his office is staying out of the investigation.
I know that the company has been selected. As to whether they've commenced their work, I won't know because I would not get involved in the day-to-day investigation or questioning that they're doing. But I know, from as far as the Office of the Prime Minister is concerned, the selection process is completed.
Back in April, Dr. Minnis revealed that an international company had been chosen to investigate the former board's removal. When asked the name of the selected company, the PM gave this response.
Allow the company to do that job.
Last year, Works Minister Desmond Bannister said the relationship with the old board members has significantly deteriorated. Former board members Darnell Osborne, Nicola Thompson, and Nick Dean hit back, calling the minister's claims untrue. The Works Minister later asserted that there was political interference only after he learned BPL paid the makeup bill for Mrs. Osborne, which she later said wasn't true. Fashion mogul Peter Nygaard's absence in this morning's court proceedings is forcing both sides to come to the table. That's attorney Fred Smith, QC, for Save the Bays, and attorney Algernon Allen for Mr. Nygaard, to formulate an informed decision on the way forward. Nygaard was convicted back in March of contempt of court and fined $50,000 by a judge for breach of the Supreme Court's order concerning illegal dredging near his property in Lyford Key. Now, Nygaard's team at the time indicated that they disagree with the judge's ruling, adding that while Nygaard paid the $50,000 fine before the specified deadline, he intended to appeal the ruling. The Court of Appeal has since struck that down. Back in January, the Winnipeg Free Press reported that the 78-year-old claimed to be sick after a warrant for his arrest was issued following his failure to attend another court hearing. In fact, Jay Prober, Nygaard's Winnipeg-based lawyer, confirmed the arrest warrant had been issued, but explained that an appeal has been filed. Prober said Nygaard, who's in Winnipeg, was too ill to travel and the arrest warrant was unnecessary and unfair given his medical condition. Attorney Algernon Allen maintains these claims, adding that he still wishes for his client's illness to be taken into consideration as they find a solution moving forward. He adds that Nygaard loves the Bahamas as he's invested millions mentally, financially, and physically. Mr. Allen assures that Nygaard wants to return to the country and is not seeking to be some rogue evading the administration of justice. Mr. Smith then replied that he may very well be a benevolent philanthropist, but respecting the court is the bottom line. Both sides agreed to try to have a court order drafted by June 18th and appear in court on the 20th at 9 a.m. Health Minister Dr. Duane Sands revealing some sobering statistics surrounding non-communicable diseases here in the Bahamas, and it all boils down to obesity. You see, 4 out of 5 Bahamians, he says, are overweight and 49.2% are obese. The minister adds that obesity also heightens one's chance of getting cancer, type 2 diabetes, renal failure, or even stroke. In fact, he says that the country's risk factor profile and related complications for NCDs is not encouraging. 90% of Bahamians eat insufficient fruits and vegetables, 72.6% have adopted a sedentary lifestyle, 16.7% are current smokers, 40.8% are current alcohol users, 58.2% have an abnormally high blood pressure, that's 132,741 persons. 23.9% are diabetic, that's 92,000 persons. 600 plus persons are on hemodialysis at an annual cost of $25 million, while 75 lower limb amputations are conducted each year. And that toll, he says, is paid not just in healthcare costs, but in a mounting pile of sick and dying Bahamians. As the war against NCDs wages on, the minister indicated that his ministry will aggressively study the world's experience with sugar sin taxes for an evidence-based recommendation. He notes that there are advocates who believe this will not only curb consumption, but also generate revenue to address the challenges of unhealthy consumption. There's also plans to introduce Bahamas Moves, a program that's a part of the Caribbean Moves initiative, geared toward encouraging increased physical activity. The Prime Minister, also responding to the opposition's criticism of the 2019-2020 budget, which they termed a budget of special interest. Dr. Minnis maintains that his government is for young people, adding that he will address that in his contribution to the budget on Wednesday.
I will define what special interest is, and I will show where our priority lies. And you, I will assure you that our priority lies with the young people, with the women, and with the future of this country. We believe in succession planning, we believe in transparency. I will demonstrate that to you, that our priority are with the development of this country and having a better future. And the young people represent the future. And that's what I would demonstrate.
While in opposition, Dr. Minnis criticized the former PLP administration for what their excessive amount of travel and money paid to consultants. The Prime Minister said he will also address that in his contribution next week.
I would want you to listen to me very carefully on Wednesday of next week when I speak. All of that would be addressed. I don't want to preempt what I'm going to say next week. But the travel, the increase in travel, my travels through the family islands, etc., all of that would be addressed. So I want you to listen attentively and very carefully.
You're watching JCN News. Stay with us.
This segment of the news was brought to you by Alive.